It's about 15 degrees outside. It is half cloudy, half sunny. It rained this morning. It rained quite a bit last night, but not a vast amount or anything, not flood level rains, but it rained a lot for what we usually get in the area. So, yeah. I was asked, I posted on Instagram the song of the day, and there was a gold thing showing at the side of my head, and I was asked what that was. It's a mask. I've got masks up there. Guy Fawkes masks, to be exact. I've got a black one with gold trim, a white one, the traditional type, and a gold one with black trim. Yippers! Yeah, they were cheap. They were not that much money at all, so it was quite good to decorate with. I think I paid $15 for the lot of them. So, you know. And my own art up there. Those are both the same, just a different color scheme. Yippers, they're abstract-y thingies. Can't remember what I named them. Something about Time Lords. Tripping the Time Lord or something like that. I don't remember. I would have to look it up, and I have like literally 10,000 works on my hard drive, so I'll never find it. So, and I haven't sorted them properly. They're just sort of in a folder. The wall art is all clumped together in one folder. The desktops are clumped together in another folder. I don't have subcategories. So, yeah. Anyways, I had my bean mix. Did that up last night. Thought I was gonna do it this morning, but I was feeling okay last night, so I did it last night, and my legs weren't that bad afterward. My feet were a little sore, but my legs weren't that bad for a change, so I got away with it. You gotta watch the split lentils though, because basically it's uncooked, 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 cooked mush, just like that. And then from the uncooked to the mush stage is about 2 minutes. So you gotta watch them. You gotta keep watching them. You look at them, you pull them out on the spoon, you look at them, and you. It's got a little, it's cooked mostly around, and there's a little dot of uncooked in the middle. That's when I add my veggies to the boiling water, and then I let it go for another 2 minutes, and it'll be done, just nice. And the veggies, you don't want to boil them for more than 2 minutes anyways. It actually stops boiling when you put the frozen veggies in, so I don't thaw them. I put them in from frozen, and they stop it from boiling. That's for damn sure. But yeah, 2 minutes in the water is good enough to blanch the vegetables and get them cooked to a desirable texture. If you overcook vegetables, it in water anyways, and just water that you're going to pour out, it destroys the nutrients, and all the vitamins and nutrients and minerals and all that are gone, and it goes down with the water basically, and it sucks them out of them. And you're throwing that away. So that was Mom's trick. She'd boil the vegetables until they were destroyed basically. I don't know if you've even seen vegetables that have been overboiled, but because most people really haven't, most people knew how to cook them. Mom did not know how to cook. She was extremely bad at it. But anyways, the peas would be a gray color. I'm not even kidding, a gray color. And yeah, the carrots would be washed out, almost a yellow color, you know. They'd be done for. And everything would have the consistency of mush. Your carrots didn't have any bite in them at all. You could crush them with your tongue into paste, basically. They were destroyed. They were destroyed. Well, that's the way it goes. But you do want to blanch them from the frozen state like that, so that they're for one thing, not frozen anymore, and another thing, it's just opens the flavor a little, and it tastes better, you know. Things like carrots, some people boil them before they put them in the stir fry. I never did. I never did that. I always just put them in the stir fry first. The stuff that takes longer to cook, like a carrot, it goes in first and whatnot, you know. You betcha. Somebody was asking about bourbon pasta sauce. It's pretty easy. Just like your normal pasta sauce. I don't recommend you using it on an Alfredo or a white sauce. It has to be a red sauce basically to taste good, because a cream-based sauce is just not. It's gonna overpower it, and all you're gonna taste is the bourbon basically. So you've got your onions and you've got your garlic and your seasonings in a little bit of oil in the pan, and you're sautéing them to open the flavors and caramelize the onions and stuff. Splash in a little bourbon to taste, basically. Different bourbons are stronger tasting than others and whatnot. So yeah. You put it in there, and you right away, basically, and you cook it up as normal like that, and then you just add in your other ingredients, your tomato paste, your crushed tomatoes, stuff like that, whatever else you want in your pasta sauce, you know. So yeah. But you want to put the spice in basically to start while you're sautéing, because it opens the flavors of the spice. You don't want to overdo it though. You don't want to put it in exactly at the beginning. You want to do it about three quarters of the way through sautéing the onions and stuff, and then it'll open up the spice and the herbs and stuff, and it'll taste better. It'll just taste better. Yeah. Ah, boy. Place that I cooked, we actually had a saucier. That's a person who specializes in sauces. And of course, he did other tasks. We weren't a big enough establishment to just have somebody doing sauce all the time, and we weren't a fancy place. So it was mid-level dining. It wasn't fancy or anything. Yeah, wasn't McDonald's, that's for sure, but it was mid-level dining. And yeah, he made all the sauces basically, and he would make them up in batches before he went on his days off, so that there would be stuff to just heat up and go. You take it out of the freezer, heat it up and go, basically. Wasn't quite as nice as the fresh stuff, but you know. Some places actually do make the sauce right there with the dish, and you can tell, because it just tastes so much better. Once you freeze the stuff, it loses some of the flavor and whatnot. And once it's sat in a container on the heat for hours, it also loses flavor, and it gets a little bit of a overcooked taste to it. So, it wasn't the best idea, but that's how we did it. Cooking the sauce to the dish is the best way. It's just the more flavorful that way. Yeah. You betcha, and you should always put your pasta, your cooked pasta, right into the sauce while you're still cooking it, and mix it in and let them cook a little bit together. And it's some people call that marrying the pasta, which is a weird term to me, but I can see why it's called that. But I don't like the term. It's a little bit hokey, if you ask me. Anyways, but yeah, that's the best way to do pasta is to toss it in the sauce after it's been thoroughly drained. Thoroughly drained and let to sit till it's totally drained. You don't want any of the water in there. If you want to thicken a sauce, a little bit of like a teaspoon of pasta water can actually be good for the sauce, but not a lot of it, not r drippy wet pasta. But like literally a teaspoon, not a tablespoon, a teaspoon into the sauce can improve it sometimes. And if you need to thicken the sauce, just reduce it down. If it's too runny, then you've got trouble. So you should use some cornstarch or something, to thicken that up. But it's going to alter the flavor. It's going to alter the flavor. Chinese restaurants use a lot of cornstarch in the stir fries and stuff to thicken the sauce, and you can tell. You really can. So, Anywho, I have said enough. That's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day. Keep smiling.